Now it's my pleasure to introduce Laetitia Bissai. Laetitia is a midwife from Cameroon. She's working in a medicalized health center in the far north of the country, and she's been doing that since 2015. Laetitia is from the first batch of midwives trained in the country, and she obtained her state registered midwife diploma in 2015. She earned a bachelor's degree in 2016, and most recently, a master's degree of public health in 2018 from the Catholic University of Central Africa. She's a member of the Cameroonian Midwives Association and the anthropology and public health community. Thank you so much for joining us today, Laetitia. I am going to make you the presenter, and you will have control of your slides.
Yeah. Thank you, Cecilia, for the introduction. At first, I've planned to present in English, but I'm seeing a lot of people very excited to have a presenter talking French. Then I would do it in French. And since also the French is my first language. Ok, notre étude est intitulée « Les déterminants des violences obstétricales à la maternité de l'hôpital central de Yaoundé ». Faut dire que la maternité, l'hôpital central de Yaoundé est un hôpital de niveau 4 dans le système de référence au Cameroun. C'est une maternité qui accueille chaque année plus de 3000 personnes et qui reçoit beaucoup d'étudiants. Étudiants médecins, étudiants sages-femmes, étudiants infirmiers et autres. Ce sont des raisons qui nous ont motivés à mener notre étude dans cette structure. Et à la base, nous voulions parler de soins humanisés. Mais au fur et à mesure que nous avancions dans la revue de littérature, nous avons découvert le terme « violence obstétricale ». Et j'avoue, moi personnellement, en tant que sage-femme, j'ai été un peu choquée par le terme parce que je me dis, il n'y a pas de sage-femme ou il n'y a pas de personnel médical qui, lorsqu'il se lève le matin, arrive au service, se prépare à être violent envers une femme qui vient pour accoucher. Et c'est la raison pour laquelle j'ai introduit ce terme dans ma recherche. Et avec raison, parce que tous les personnels à qui j'ai eu affaire ont été étaient vraiment sceptiques par rapport à ce terme-là. Donc, voilà. Ok, on va rentrer d'abord. Je sélectionne la deuxième diapositive. Voilà. Donc, on a un plan sommaire de notre présentation là qui aura une introduction. Quelques éléments de contexte, la méthodologie que nous avons employée pour mener cette étude, quelques résultats, une synthèse de ces résultats-là, une conclusion et des suggestions que nous avons formulées à l'égard des concernés. Donc, tout d'abord, en guise d'introduction, lors de notre revue de littérature, nous avons vu que la stratégie mondiale pour la santé des femmes, de l'enfant et de l'adolescent visait d'ici à 2030 la réduction de la mortalité maternelle à au moins 70 pour 100 000 naissances vivantes. Et que l'une des stratégies clés pour atteindre cet objectif, c'était l'assistance de la femme par un personnel qualifié avant, pendant et après l'accouchement. Ceci est l'une des raisons pour lesquelles des pays qui ne... qui n'avaient pas de formation de sage-femme, notamment les pays africains comme le mien, ont décidé d'introduire cette formation en 2011. Et il est dit aussi que les compétences essentielles pour un accoucheur qualifié doivent être à la fois cliniques, cognitives et relationnelles. Mais nous nous sommes rendus compte que la présence de barrières interpersonnelles entre les prestataires de soins et les patientes sont pressenties être comme une interface dans l'augmentation du nombre d'accouchements par un personnel qualifié. Parce qu'il faut noter qu'ici, dans notre contexte, en milieu urbain comme en milieu rural, encore plus de 30% des accouchements se font dans des structures non spécialisées pour cela. Donc, à partir des résultats de l'OMS, nous avons appris que dans le monde, beaucoup de femmes, ce n'est pas seulement le cas des pays africains, beaucoup de femmes font encore l'expérience des traitements non respectueux et des mauvais traitements lors de l'accouchement en établissement de soins. Et l'Argentine, qui est bien avancée par rapport à beaucoup de pays, que ce soit en Europe ou aux Amériques, a reconnu déjà le droit des femmes à ne pas être victimes de violences lors de l'accouchement en établissement de soins.
Et Laetitia?
Si, enfin. Yes.
Can you give some of your points in English? You had many listeners who were hoping to hear some about Cameroon in English.
Okay, when I reach the level of Cameroon, I will talk in English.
Okay.
Donc, à ce niveau, si nous disons que l'Argentine, elle a reconnu ce droit de façon législative. Et jusqu'à présent, même s'il existe des données scientifiques suggérant que le manque de respect et des mauvais traitements vécus par les femmes, il n'existe pas encore à l'heure actuelle de consensus international sur la manière dont devrait être défini et mesuré ce manque de respect et ces mauvais traitements. En Afrique. Et c'est in Africa. In 2016, the government and one NGO conducted a study entitled Études exploratoires sur les violences faites aux femmes dans les services de santé. And from that study, we realized that more than 40% of women are complaining the care they receive in the health structure. In Tanzania also, they conducted a study on the prevalence of the irrespect and the abuse in the health centers and also in urban area. Because most of the time we think it's only in a rural area that we can observe those treatments, but some studies shows that even in rural in urban area, we even more than 50% of women, as in Tanzania, are complaining of the care they receive. Actually, in Cameroon, what we can say about it is that our strategic evaluation of the health sector is showing that the results that are presented they are due to the poor results that are presented are due to, first of all, the lack of a certain number of material in the health structure, but also due to the fact that patients are not happy or are not are complaining with the quality of the they are welcome in the health structure, and some practice like because you know in Cameroon there is not health insurance. Most of the time patients are paying from their pocket, and for it there is a lack of observance, and some health personnel, and most of the time the health personnel are like taking money from the patient and asking them more than what is supposed to be. With the GIZ, we realize a short film that was for the students, for the student midwife. And the aim of that film was to sensitize them against their role in the maternity on what they should not do. And more recently, on one French media, France 24, they show from one interview women that in our maternities here in Cameroon, and especially this maternity we work in, that many women are still marginalized, and they are still marginalized, and most of the time they're even held in the health structure when they can't pay their bill after delivery. Sometimes they even return their babies. Okay, to conduct this study, as I said it already, it was in one maternity of the Central Hospital of Yaounde, which is a fourth category maternity, and which is receiving most of the medical midwife, nurses, student of the town. And our target population was the health practitioners, the parturient, and the new mothers. And we included the in this study the health practitioners and also the women that were coming in the maternity for the delivery or who were in the postnatal ward. At the end, we had 29 health practitioners that participated to our study, and we interviewed 7 women, and we did 18 observations for the delivery. We have to precise that we use an observation guide, which is not from us, but from the White Ribbon Alliance. We use also an interview guide to collect information from women and also from the health practitioners. And from there, we realized that we had several type of determinants at the origin of obstetrical violences in that structure. First of all, institutional determinants. They were the most common and most of the violence observed were depending on them. First of all, we have the workload. We can observe that in that maternity, the health professionals, especially the midwives, they are working in two shifts. Then we have the morning shift and the evening shift. They are working in team, and each team for a maternity that is having 5 delivery beds, we have 2 midwives working per shift. It is too much. After it, we discovered that the social professional category also, because from our discussions with the health practitioners, we discovered the gynecologists were more happy with their work than the midwives and the nurse. Let's say in our context here, the midwifery or nursing are not till now considered as category apart. They're still like depending on the medical practitioners, and the medical practitioners are the one giving them orders on what to do or not what to do, and it's creating some frustration. Then most of them are not satisfied with their work. Also, we discovered that the way they are welcoming people is not standardized. The hygiene also. The women are complaining for the hygiene. We observed that the hygiene was not that good. And even the health personnel is complaining from the hygiene in that maternity. The patients, they don't give the time to the patient to, in fact, they are not even giving the information to the patients. Most of the time, patients are not asking. I think that also has an origin, that is the educational level, because here most of the patients are still considering that the health practitioner is like a let me say like a god. What he said is what should be done. Most of the time they are not asking for information, and even when they are asking, the informations are not given to them because the health personnel are considering that they are not, they maybe they can't understand what is done. They are not asking for the consent before doing before carrying a procedure on a patient, and also they are retaining patients, women that deliver that cannot pay their bills. They are retaining them. They are retaining them in the health structure. And those determinants are also psychologic, because we discovered the way the health personnel are perceiving, most of the health personnel are perceiving their relationship with their patient like difficult. Also, the patient are not developing with their midwives a delivery plan. The central hospital of Yaounde is a referral structure, and most of the time women that are coming for delivery there are coming from some other structures of low levels, and they are coming that maybe they started to carry some procedure on them in those places where they were, and the procedure failed. Then they refer them to that level. Most of the time they come, they don't have money. Most of the time they come that the situation is already bad. And this affects the quality of the relation they have with those midwives they meet there. Midwives also abuse the women. And from the women, and according to women, According to mothers, let me say mothers or new delivery women, the female midwives are more harsh than male. They don't permit to them to have a companion during the delivery. And also the privacy is not really observed. So there is a room with 5 beds, and they consider that every health professional that is coming has the right to see or to do. The women cannot ask for privacy. In fact, it's really difficult at that level. Psychologically, most of the time they consider in our context that women should deliver in the pain. Then when one woman is really shouting or crying, instead of maybe coming beside her and trying to alleviate her pain, they are most of the time shouting on her and asking her to try to do like others and stop shouting and making noise, which is not good. And also for the sociocultural aspect, as I was saying just before, they consider in our context that a woman should deliver through pain, and a real woman is the one that is bearing her pain without crying or without shouting. And when someone cannot cope with the pain and is just like shouting and expressing her pain, the health personnel is that shouting on her, which is not good and favoriting obstetrical violences. And the relationship between the health personnel and the patient also is not symmetric. They consider that the health personnel is on top and the patient is down and is supposed to respect and understand all what is told to him. There is not really some norms and regulations, and most of the health personnel don't even know the right of the patient.
Okay. Okay, from those institutional determinants, I don't know what to do, because here I take some passages from our interviews with the women, as one of the women we interviewed said to us, l'accouchement est trop coûteux. Je peux prendre le cas de ceux qui sont coincés là-bas. On a trouvé une qui avait déjà fait plus d'une semaine parce qu'elle n'avait pas d'argent. Donc, si sa famille ne lui vient pas en aide, elle va faire un an là avec l'enfant. Ils doivent aussi être indulgents. This was a case where one lady was retained in the hospital. That was more than 1 week after the practitioner has signed her discharge, because she can't pay for the bill. She was still in the hospital, and another woman was like begging for her and asking that, so are they able to keep her for 1 year if her relative don't come to pay for her bill? They should try to understand the population, in fact, people. Another one was saying to us, la major a demandé à un infirmier de retirer la perfusion et de trouver mon dossier, mais c'est où? Elle a parlé jusqu'à bavarder, jusque comme on lève d'ici, parce qu'ici, c'est facile de m'oublier, mais personne, est-ce que c'est normal? This was a case where a lady came in the hospital and the place was bonded, so they kept her in one place and almost forgot about her. When I went to her and she was explaining to me that the ward charge said to a nurse to look for a better place for her. That was more than 1 hour already, and she was still there, and nobody came even to give her any information, even to talk to her, and she was really disappointed with that situation. And for the psychological aspect, one of our interview revealed one lady that was saying, dans la salle d'accouchement, ils sortent de l'école. Non, il y a une façon de travailler qu'on leur apprend. Je ne sais pas si c'est aux patients de leur apprendre ça. Je me dis qu'ils sont censés nous accueillir, nous dorloter, parce que accoucher, c'est une quasi-mort. Je peux sortir de là vivante ou morte. Donc, je ne me suis pas sentie rassurée. Mais bon, j'entrais là-bas en guerrière. Je savais déjà ce qui m'attendait à l'avance. This was also a lady that complained about the care they gave to her. And she was wondering if the nurse and midwife that were in the maternity did not receive during their trainings the technique and the way they are supposed to manage women that are coming to deliver. So she was saying they should pay them because the delivery is like she is almost dead. She can be alive at the end as she can be dead. So she was not very reassured with the way people attend to her. But she was coming knowing already what was waiting for her. You understand that women are coming to us, but with already something in mind. And that is most of the time due to other patients that came before and who explained to them out of the health structure, how the care is rendered in that structure. So when she comes, she has already in her mind that people are not nice there, they will not pay her, they will not attend to her the way, so she's coming prepared for it already, which is not good. Also, another one complained of, on ne me gérait pas parce que je n'avais pas d'argent, on m'insultait même, tu fais même quoi ici, tu envahis la chambre. Voilà d'autres femmes qui viennent là. So, this one that was a woman that came and she was not having money. And she said that the health personnel was talking harshly to her and abusing her. That what are you even doing here? You are keeping space when other women are coming to deliver. Look for money and go out. And also from our observations, from one of our observations, where a lady had a tear after the delivery, then the doctor came to repair that tear, and as she was crying and shouting and trying to retain them, the nurse started to talk to her and telling her, if your hand still touch me, I will slap you. You can take heart, let us finish with you, but you are shouting, if the doctor leave you, that will be bad for you. That's the way one nurse talked to one lady that just gave birth and had a tear in front of me. Okay. In conclusion, as we said, our objective was to look at the determinant of obstetrical violences at the maternity. Then from there, we discovered that there are some determinants that are coming from the institution, their procedure, the way they interact, first of all, among them, health personnel. Doctors are not respecting midwives, are not respecting nurses. Also, the workload for those midwives when they should be two for one shift, working from 7 a.m. till 5 p.m. and working from 5 p.m. till 7 a.m. the next morning, it is very, very heavy for two person, and sometimes per night they can attend to 10 or 15 women, which is too heavy. And also from psychological aspect, women are coming because the hospital has acquired already a bad reputation. So women are coming already prepared in their mind that people will be harsh with them. They should not ask anything. They should be quiet. They should try to, in fact, they don't feel at ease when coming because they have already those ideas in their mind. And also they don't permit to them the configuration of the maternity room is not permitting to them to allow the birth companion to be in the rooms, which is not helping women psychologically. And from the sociocultural aspect, here from women, the obstetrical violences are too frequent, extremely frequent. So sometimes when you decide to conduct a study like this one, they even see it as a strange phenomenon to talk about it, because for them, all what they are doing is already in their practice and is almost normal. Okay, we suggested We identify some problem, specify the causes and consequences, and we suggest some recommendations to the main actors. Like all those dysfunction we observe in the maternity room, we said this is due to the lack of material, also the disponibility of drugs and the health product. And this has some consequences that because the procedure most of the time are rupture, when you have to send a patient to the pharmacy to go and bring you maybe a catheter, that the time the relative is going to the maternity, what will happen to the woman that is there in need? and that also frustrate the patient. But there is no stock of drugs and product for the maternity, just beside that they can take and maybe set the bill at the end for the patient. For every single thing, they have to send a relative to the pharmacy, which is not good. And this was addressed to the Ministry of Public Health and also for the administration of the hospital. For the workload, this is due to the lack of personnel. And as consequently, the small number of personnel that are there available cannot render the care that patient expect. And they cannot do the individualized care at that moment. They need to recruit personnel and to define a good politic of recruitment. Because in that health structure also, most of the time some students are after their training, they are coming for the perfectionnement, like to perfect their skills before entering, and even the hospital not taking care of them. When that is a good source of human resources for the maternity, they can use them for that time they are coming for to perfect their skills after their diploma, to enhance the work and to complete their teams that are working in the units and render a better care to the people. There is insufficiency in the organization of the care. I think they lack competencies, they lack motivations, and this leads to a late disorder, first of all, a late in the way they are attending to people. They should reinforce the capacity of the health team and really reinforce it, not only without making une évaluation de leur personnel de façon permanente. And there is insufficient communication between in the team, first of all, with the administration and also with the patients. I think this is not because they don't want, but they lack competencies in communications. They are not taking the consent of the patient, and I think they really need to be reinforced in communication. And this is the role of the Ministry of Public Health, the administration of the hospital, and also the associations like the Midwife Association in Cameroon.
Laetitia, I think you are close to the end of your presentation. We have about 5 minutes left. Can you maybe summarize, and then people might have some questions?
Okay, let me summarize.
Your suggestions were actually good summaries.
Okay, thank you. So our study aimed at the identification of obstetrical violence determinants at the Central Hospital Maternity of Yaoundé, and also to contribute to the understanding of the way patients and the women who have recently given birth perceive the care given to them during that particular delicate stage of their life. So we use a mixed approach, and from that we realize that the lack of human resources, both on quantitative and qualitative aspect, are for more in the manifestation of these violences. And also the educational aspect, both from the health caregivers and the patient side, although it was not taken into consideration, there seems from our result to be from a great impact in the poor quality of care given to women in labor. Okay. Thank you for this opportunity you gave me to do this presentation to you.
Laetitia, I think we have heard a midwife leader of the future. For you to be able to go back and forth, French and English, is a real skill. I can only imagine that your midwifery skills are as great. Elena is asking, she's wondering if you have plans to present these findings to the people you have identified, for example, the Ministry of Health and others.
Oh, actually, I've been able to present it to them because there is a lot of procedure to access to that level. And I think you, as personally, as individual, is almost impossible. But if you are carrying by a structure that is really representative for the ministry, maybe at that time you can have that opportunity to be heard if you present this.
Excellent. What about getting the information out to midwifery journals in English, Laetitia?
This study was conducted, at the end of the year 2018. Then when I saw the opportunity to present it, first of all, to the virtual conference, I thought it was a first step to make people to see or to appreciate what is done or what people are living here at my level. So if there are some other opportunity to present this study, I'm ready to take them.
Laetitia, in the chat box, Elena Ateva, who's from White Ribbon Alliance, I believe, says she would like to follow up with you. And she's given her email address at the White Ribbon Alliance. She says you can write in French. And I think she is going to help you spread this information.
Okay.
All right. Laetitia, again, thank you so much. I don't know if the listeners know, but we lost our French translator at the last minute, and Laetitia was brave enough to speak in English. I hope, Laetitia, you'll consider joining us in future years and updating us on what your work is doing.
Okay.